Hi everyone, good morning. Welcome to the third session of Base SAS. So we are going to cover today reading data sets and subsetting data sets. We'll talk about labels and we'll talk about formats, that what are the formats and labels in SAS. So before I go ahead with the terms called reading and subsetting data sets, so let me just tell you that in our previous call, we saw some options or functions which were used to subset data sets, like where, or we did work with a lot of operators and operands. So let me just continue with them. And I would like to show here that these are the comparison operators. I told you in the previous class that we can use these functions to subset our data sets. So let me just tell you that you can use symbols like this, equal to, or you can use EQ as well at the place of equal to, right? And how you are going to use that? Either you can write A is equal to 3, or you can write A EQ 3. In same way, not equal to, you can write in all these three types, all right? Or you can write NE, like they have given an example here, that ANE3. So this is not equal to. Same way, greater than we have less than, we have greater than or equal to, or you can write less than or equal to, and similarly in. So in will work in the same way as we have been working into SQL Server. All right. So let's see. Now we have arithmetic operators. What are arithmetic operators? Arithmetic operators indicate that an arithmetic calculation is performed, right? And when we say arithmetic calculation, it could be your multiplication, addition, division, subtraction, or exponentiation. Exponentiation is nothing but the power. Like you want to create the power, or you want to get the power of any number, right? So these are the various mathematical operators which you can use to perform some mathematical calculation. Now we have logical operators. Logical operators in all subjects are always same. That's AND, or NOT. But here in SAS environment, we have a different symbols. So for AND, we will be using this AND. Then OR, we have two pipeline operators, and then we have, you know, exclamatory sign between them. And NOT, then we have these three things which you can write NOT, right? And at the place of these symbols, you can use your syntax like this as well, all right? So the symbol you use or not depends on the operating environment. So in Unix, you will have a different sign, and in Windows, you will have a different sign. So create a data set subset 2 from the sales that list only product line, children, or even numbered for even numbered year, and profit greater than $500. So you should get 63 observation. I mean, they have given one exercise here. So we'll be doing that. Let me go to SAS environment so that we can, you know, perform the same task. So I have already opened a SAS session. This. All right. So what they want us to do, they want us to create a data set subset 2 from sales. Okay. So I told you that in library SAS help, we have a data set called OR sales, right? Right now you cannot see that, but let me show you. Proc print, you might remember how to see it, because I have already told you several times that how to use this proc print. You need to give data. So I'll give the reference to the library, then dataset name, that is OR sales. I'll terminate my statement, and then I will write run. So as soon as I will write this or I will run this, you can see that I will get an output, and that will show the OR sales data set. Now you might wonder that from the beginning till now I have been using, you know, proc print statement, and I have been getting the result into a separate window, whereas I already have a window called output. All right, so this is what I have, you know, you can say I have already added this option to see the output in this window. But otherwise, what you can do is you can go to tools, then options, you have preferences here, then you have result tab, and at the place of this create HTML, you can uncheck this. All right. I've unchecked that and I'm going to click OK. So let's see how I'm going to get my results now. Okay, so it said that no output destination active. Right now, I was supposed to get output here, but I haven't got that yet. So for that, I will have to, you know, change some settings. And next thing, I will have to go back to the same options, then preferences, and I will have to say create listing. Listing is but nothing but the output listing, what I'm going to get here. So if I run it now, you will see the result in output window like this. All right, now the other window is not getting popped up. I'm getting all the result into the output window only. So let me go back to the exercise. What it said, create a subset, data set subset. So I told you that how to create data sets. To create a data set or a subset, what you need to write is, you need to write data, then you need to give reference to a library. So let's say I have a library called Satya here. I will say Satya dot the subset. This, okay. So this would be the name of new data set which I am going to create. Now, how I want to create it? So for that, I will have to use input data set that I am getting from SAS help library, and my data set would be OR sales, right? So I have already shown you that where this data set is, OR sales. Now the condition they want us to put in, that the only product line children for even number for even numbered years. Okay, so first of all, let us put only children as a product line. So you might have seen that in the database, the output which we have got, we have a column here, product category or the product line. Basically, they want us to put a filter on product line and only children. So for that, I'll go back to SAS environment editor window, and I will write where product line is equal to children. I'll copy the children here. Paste that into the children quotes, and then I will say run. All right. My syntax is complete, but before I run this program, let me tell you that SAS is not a case sensitive environment. So where SAS reads Satya or SATYA or Satya, all of them as the same character or same string, But if you are specifying that into quotes, then it would treat it as a case sensitive. Until unless you are not putting quotes in around it, it will not treat or it will not be case sensitive. So if you want to check or validate a particular value, then you will have to validate, put it into strings, or not strings, I would say, you will have to put it into single quotes, so that SAS will, you know, understand that it has to be case sensitive. Now I'm going to run my query, which I have already written here. So let's see what I'm going to get now. Right, you can see that SAS subset got created. Now first of all, before I see this data set, I'll go and check my log window. It's recommended for you as well that try to see the log window, try to get familiar with log window as soon as you can be, right? Because log window tells you each and everything that what is happening in the backend. So here it says that data satya.subset2 set sashelp.orsales, so where product line is equal to children, run. There were 176 observation read from data set sashelp.orsales. Where product line is equal to children, the data set satya.subset2 has 176 observation and 8 variables. Alright. And it said that real time took this much and CPU time is this much. So we have created a data set. Now there are two ways I can see the data set. Either I can double click on it, it will open the data set for me. Wait a minute, it is opening the data set for us. Here we go. We have got all the records where product category or the product line is children. Alright, I'll close this. The other way of looking at the same data would be, I use proc print and run. So it has shown you the output for subset 2 data set. All right. Now let me clear this window first. Clear all. We are again back to our editor window. But you might have a question here that till now whatever proc print I have been using, I have been giving data and then reference to library and then the name of data set, but this time I have not done that. I have just written proc print and run. So let me tell you that whenever you run this statement wherein you are not specifying your data set, you are directly running this program or the proc print function or statement, SAS identifies that you want to run the last created data set. Okay, so whenever you will run this much statement without specifying your data set name or the library name, it will automatically pick the last most created data set or the latest data set. So in our case, if I go to library, then subset 2 was the latest data set which was created, and that is why you have got it, or it you know, it have printed that data set. But let me tell you that looking at the output into this output window is not that you know, good or user friendly. So I will switch back to the same window which I had earlier. Now you may understand that why I have been looking in at that window, or why I had enabled that window, because I love to see the output on this Explorer window. All right, so I have turned that on. It takes, you know, it takes a time. No, this time it didn't work. You can see into the log window, it says writing HTML body file sas html.htm, but it did not open. Okay, So I will have to close this listing first of all. Listing means the output window, whatever you get into output window, and it will start using this create HTML. So I will, you know, open it again. I'll go back and I'll run it again. So I've got the result into the Explorer window again. So this result looks good. When you look at this, it looks beautiful. All right. Now if you click F9, you get this window. All right. Where I just clicked F9 and I have got this window. It tells you all the keys and the definition that what they do. All right. So here you can say that F1 is for help, F2 is for reshow, F3 is for end or gsubmit buffer default, F4 is for recall, F7 is for output. Similarly, there are keys which do not have been assigned anything, but you can see that clear it has been assigned to Control E. Okay, or apart from this, if you want to assign anything, you can write here and click save. Okay, now I'm going to close it, and if I press F12 here, you can see the log got cleaned or the output got cleaned. If I go here and click F12, you can see all the logs which were there in the log window got cleaned. So this is how you can, you know, assign a definition to a key. So this is again very, if you are, you know, if you need to work with a lot of short keys or fast keys, you can, you know, assign the operation to those keys and you can work. So this is exactly, you know, the good programmers do. This is the best practice or the good practice to follow. So I will recommend you to create some, you know, keys, fast keys for yourself so that you can use them and work, right? Alright, so it says Control B is for library. Let me just do Control B into Control B. Okay, I've got the a list of libraries here. So again, yes, it's working. Alright, now let me go back to the slide. On the slide basically it said that create a data set subset 2 from sales that lists only product line children for even numbered years and profit greater than $5,000. So till now I have put only one condition, and that was that the product line children. Now I am going to put another condition that says the profit should be greater than $5,000. So you can see here that profit column is this. I'm gonna put this condition and, right? So you will be using and operator with the latest condition. So I will write and profit should be greater than 5,000. All right. Now I already have this subset 2. If I do not mention a new name, it will overwrite my previous data set, that is subset 2. So let me show you that I'm going to create third data set called subset 3. I'll run this condition or the program. Subset 3 got created, and if I run this query, it will run the latest one. It means subset 3. You can see this is the subset 3 now here. So all the records or the profit, you can see that is greater than $5,000. You will not see a single record with less than or equal to $5,000. Now this time I have got 122 records, but my exercise or the result says that I'll be getting 63 observations, but I have 122 records. Why? Because we are still left with one condition that says for even numbered years. So now we need to put even numbered years. Now, what is the way by which I will find out only the even numbers? Do you have any idea? All right, let me tell you. So even numbered years, you can see in the year. Okay, so let us use mod. Let's see what I'm going to get. I'll put another condition into this, and I have column years, right? This even numbered years. So I will say into the editor window, I'll write mod years divided by 2 should be 0. Let's see what it does. It ran. I need to check into, okay, function mod requires at least 2 arguments. So the mod function which we have used is not correct. Okay, I may be missing something in the mod function. All right, let me check. Okay, so this is the best place where I can show you that how to look for help into SAS. Okay, I will go to this book icon which says help, or you can click F1. The another window will open, and then we will see the mod function. All right, now you should also see that how to get help from the SAS. I have put mod, it says mod function, and it says mod function returns the remainder from the division of first argument by the second argument. Division of first argument by the second argument. So what is the syntax? It will tell you that how to write that syntax. So basically the place where I use I use the divide sign or the divisible sign, you need to just use comma, right? Now if we run it, let's see what's it gonna do. I will go back to the log window again, and it said that it started from here, and it said that there were 63 observation read from the data set sashelp.orsales. So you can see that we have got the same number of observation as were told into the file, that you should get 63 observation. We have got 63 observation, and if I run this query to see the output in the output window, here we go. You have the result here, and you can see that we have got maximum 63 records. So what I have done, I have put a filter and then created a data set for product line children, for profit greater than 5000, and year should be, where year is divisible by, or I would say year has the even numbers. All right, now another thing which I wanted to show before this program, I created subset 3 when I put 2 conditions. Now what I have done, I have put 3 conditions and I have run the same program. So what would have happened, the dataset 3 got overwritten. Okay, so if I put the same output dataset name and I change the condition, so irrespective of the conditions, whatever new dataset will be created will replace my existing dataset. So you need to be aware of it, or you need to be, you know, I would say, yes, you should be aware or conscious. Make it sure that you want to overwrite your old dataset or not. If you don't want, change the name of your output data set. And if you want to replace or override the old one, you can give the same name. Okay, so it was a good practice for us. Let's move on to the next slide. So we have done this exercise. This is what they have given here. Now they have given done the same exercise with a different way. They have said that year in 2000 or 2012. What we have done, we have used mod function and then we have tried to find out the result. But the other way of doing that is they have given years into in clause. But for this, you must have the knowledge that what are all years in the data set. So they, I mean, whoever have written this example must have, been aware of that there are 2000 and 2002, only two entries for the even years. So that is why they have mentioned those two things here. Otherwise, you can use to make it dynamic that mod. Mod function remains same across Excel, SQL, and SAS. So you can use it anytime to find the even numbers or the odd numbers. If I would have to find odd numbers, I should have written is not equal to zero. So every time or in each condition, it will give me, I should say, a reminder. Okay. So this is how you're gonna create or find all the even numbers. So let's move on to the next slide. It says assignment, and here what we are going to do is that navigate to help and in index type in between and operator explain the following with example. So basically now our next topic would be to work on all these things, whether between and, is null, is missing, contains or like. All right. So let's move to these topics. To explain the following between and up to like, we will need the following data set called cards, which we will create conditionally from sashelp.cards. So let's see, do we have the data set into SAS help or not? So I will write the same thing, that proc print data is equal to SAS help dot car, then run. So as soon as I'll be running this proc, you will see some output, and if it is not there, means I'm doing something wrong. So you can see that it said that file sashelp.car.data does not exist. I will have to go manually into the library SAS help and I need to check it out whether we have car data set here or not. Okay, we have cards, not car, we have cards. So I'll go back and check or change my query to cards and then I'll run this again. So you can see we have got the result. Like we have make model type origin drivetrain, right? We have MSRP mark. Then we have invoice, engine size, cylinders, horsepower, MPG underscore city, then MPG underscore highway, weight, wheelbase, and length. So we have got the data for SAS help library and the cars data set. Now what they wanted us to do is that please run the following code and create the data set. Okay, so they have put in clause here, sorry, if clause, and they are using n. What is this underscore n underscore? Okay, let us use this and then we'll find it out that what is n underscore n is. Okay, let me go back to the slide. Cars, I'll go to SAS environment, my editor window. I have just pasted that code. So So what they are going to do is, I will create this cards data set again into the SAPTIA library, and I'll run this. So what will happen, I'll go through the log window, it will tell us. Okay, it said there were 428 observation read from the dataset sashelp.cards. The dataset SAPTIA cards has 100 observation and 15 variables. 100 observation means 100 rows, and 15 observation means 15 columns. The data statement used total process time, this. Okay, now let's see the data set, that how, what kind of data set it has created for us. So I'll run this and we will get the output into result window. Okay, so this resultant output has only 100 rows. And all right, now let me show you, let me create another data set which gonna tell you that what exactly the code is doing. Okay, so I will first of all write, I'll eliminate these two things, I'll run this code, I'll go back and proc print. So as per my code, I wanted that where underscore and underscore should be less than or equal to 100, less than or equal to 100. Okay, this was the first condition. So they have given that. Now basically this is nothing but the observations, right? So this is the observation column. It just puts a condition that observation should be less than or equal to 100. It should not be more than 100. Right? Now the second condition was, they wanted this n underscore n in 10, 20, 40, 30, then cylinder is equal to missing. For these fields, cylinder should be missing. So if I implement the second condition, I'll go back to my data set. So it said for 10, 20, let me show you that again. For 10, cylinder should be missing. Right now you can see 6 here. Now let me put that code and see that whether we are getting the right thing or is it something else. I've run it again. I will go back to the results window again. Okay. So you can see where my observation is 10, I have got missing as a cylinder. So earlier I was getting 6, but now we have missing value. So it says that wherever observation n underscore n is in 10, 20, 30, 40. So if I go back and check for the 20th row, I would have the same situation over there. If I go back to the 30th row, I will have the same situation over there. If I go back to the 40th row, I will have the same situation over there, and same for row number 50. Alright, now let us implement the third condition. What was that? It says that if observation is in between 15, 25, 30, 45, 55, then type is equal to blank, right? So for 15th row, let's see what is there in the 15th row. And the type, so we have for 15th row, we have cdn as type. So as soon as I will be implementing this, you know, this condition, I will have blank as in type. So I'll go there and I'll write another statement and I'll run my query and I'll, you know, proc print my state data set once again. So you can see on the 15th row we have blank here, right? 15th we have blank. Now you can say that in cylinder I was getting a dot over there, but in case of you know, type, it's blank, there's nothing. All right, Let me tell you that what exactly happens, or we'll be discussing it later that what is a missing value. Okay, I'll be discussing later on that what is a missing value in SAS, and that's a very important topic. So keep remember, I'll come to that point. So much later down the line, we see that the code does. However, for the inquisitive, we are creating a subset of sashelp.cards where we initially filter out the only first 100 observations. Within that, we change the value of variable cylinder to the missing for 5 observation, where observation was 5, 20, 30, and 40, and 50. And do the same for 5 observation for variable type. Alright, so we have, you know, changed the values to missing values for these observations. So these were the topics which were left from the first session. Now let's move on to the next slide, which I wanted to cover today. And in continuation with a lot of functions, we have between and, right? So let's read that what it's talking about, and we'll be, you know, using them. So this, it says the between and condition outputs all observations that fall within a range specified by the said statement. For example, our data set car has various cylinder size between 1.6 liter and 6 liters. The following code will print out the observation that have engine size between 2 liter and 4 liter. So basically, till now whatever we have been doing with the car's data set, now we are going to put another condition. And this time I'll be creating another data set, engine size. Okay. So I'll change the name of output data set, and I will say data Satya dot engine size. Let's say size. All right. I've given this a name, engine size, and now my conditions will change. So what condition I want to specify here? That where engine size, so engine size is given into this column. Sorry, I need to come here, where engine size is between, what condition I need to give, 2 and 4. All right, so I want all the records where engine size is between 2 and 4. I want all those records for cards where engine size is between 2 and 4, and that to be saved into engine size data set. So I'll be, you know, copying this proc so that I can reuse it. Here we go. And I will run all these once again. I've selected both of them and ran. So it has created the data set for me, and you can see here that engine size would be between 2 and 4. When I say 2 and 4 and I'm using between, so it will cover 2 as a minimum value and 4 as a maximum value. So including these two, it will provide me the complete values which will fall between 2 and 4, including 2 and 4. So all the records where you see, you have minimum value as 2 and maximum value as 4. I haven't seen 4 yet, but yes, we have a 4 here. All right. So it will show you all the records wherein you have, you know, values between in engine size column, the values between 2 and 4. So this is how you can use between and function into SAS for subsetting. It says the two values need not to be in ascending order. Okay. And using the condition between 4 and 2 will output the same result. So it's a very good thing to know that it's really not necessary that you give 2 and 4. You can give 4 and 2 as well. But however, you will get the same output in both the conditions. When using character value, the same condition outputs in alphabetical order. So similarly, they have used another condition here or another proc. So let me just go back, and I will be also writing the same thing here. similar kind of function which says, let's say where, I'll take any other thing, let's say it will take alphanumeric things. So let's say make, I'm also going to take make between Acura. So it's nothing but it will see the alphanumeric thing, all right, or the alphabetical order, not exactly the alphanumeric things, it will check the alphanumeric order. And I, let's say Porsche, and I'll run all these queries. So this is the result which I wanted to see. So I have make as an Acura, and then if I go to the last, I have Porsche. So it has given me all the records between Porsche and Acura. So this is how, you know, you can use between and either for numbers or for string or character type of, you know, variables. Okay, let's move. On the next slide, we have is null and missing, or is missing. So it said is null as well as is missing can be used to output observations that have a missing value. They can both be used for a character as well as a numeric value. The two examples below. Alright, so it says that proc print data is equal to car, where cylinders is missing for numeric field. Or for character field, you can write proc print data is equal to cards, where type is missing. Okay, so before I go ahead on this example, let me tell you that what is a missing value in SAS. So similarly, as we have null in SQL Server, right? Null value. Null means nothing. In same way, in SAS, suppose that if you leave anything blank, okay? Let me show you. I will create a data set right now for you, and then I'll be using a missing value into that. So I have not told you yet that how to create a data set using data lines, though I have shown you the examples. So let me create a data. I'll save it into Satya library, and I'll say test. I guess I already have a lot of test data sets over there. So in Satya. Oh great, I don't have any test data set. So test, and then I will write input where I need to specify my variables. Let's say I will give variables as ID, then I will give variable ID is to be integer. So let me tell you that there are only two type of data types in SAS. Normally if I talk about SQL Server or other tools which we use, we have a lot of data types available, but in SAS we have only two data types. One is numeric and another is string. So for numeric, when we, you know, create data set, we do not specify anything with the name of variable, but for you know, character type or string type, we need to use a dollar sign. Okay, so let me use a dollar sign here like this, and after this dollar you can specify the length. Let's say I have given 10 and I will end my statement. So what it will do is, if I do not mention the length 10, so it will by default it will take 8 length for the name variable, but I have given 10, so it will be up to 10. Now I will write data lines. And below data lines, you can give the value for these variables, ID and name. So let's say I have given 1 for ID. I will give a space, and then I will give a name called Satendra. Then I will take 2. Then I'll take, say, John. Then I'll take 3. I will leave it, then I will go back. Okay, I'll give it 5, 4, and then I will give RAM. I'll leave it blank, give it a space, and then I will give Jeff. Again, I will give 6, space, James, 7, Thomas, 9, Kathy, 10, Irene. Okay, so I have given various values here, and when I will, you know, run this statement, a data set will be created, but you will not be sure that what is the order in which the values got inserted. So right now it would be a confusion state for you, and I would say that try to understand this as per your own. Later on I will tell you that what is the mechanism which has been followed to insert the data, and this is the main reason, that is why I didn't tell you how to create data set using data lines yet. So I'll be telling that later, but right now I'm running this and you can see that what kind of data set it's gonna create for you. It has created test, and if I run proc print statement, so you can see that it has created a set for you, and this is the output, right? You can see it has done, blunder. You might not understand that what it has done to create this data set. All right. And right now I'm not going to tell you the logic that why it did like this, but later on I will explain each and everything that why it did. So basically, if you look into this data set, you got a dot here in case of ID field, and for all name columns you have spaces or blank, right? So I wanted to talk to you about missing value. Missing values. Okay, so in SAS we have, depending on the data types, we have two type of missing values. It could be your numeric field, numeric value, or it could be your string. All right. So there could be two type of missing values, either numeric or string. String basically not, I should use character here. Okay. So for character and numeric, I shown you the data set. This was the numeric field. I have got a dot here, and for character or string I have got blanks. So this is exactly happens when we get a missing value into the data set. We get a missing value as a dot for integer field or numeric field, and we get blanks for character or string type of data or variables. So this is exactly how, missing values behave. So I'll go back to the same example where I was. This, that proc print data is equal to car, where cylinder is missing. So basically I'm not going to specify a blank here, or in the second example, I'm not going to, in the first example, I'm not going to specifying a dot, or in second example, I'm not going to specifying a missing, blank. At the place of that, I'm going to write is missing. Okay, so is missing function will do the same job what a dot for numeric field or blank for character field is going to do. But is null is again the same thing. It says that is null as well as is missing can be used to output observation that has a missing value. So let me check that whether we have a missing value. Okay, I can use this missing value into this column or this So I will write the same statement that proc print data is equal to Satya dot test, and I will write where I'm just printing, right? I'm writing where ID is missing. Run. If I run this statement, let's see what I'm gonna get. I have clicked on F8, and you can see that I have got only one record. Okay, because there was only one record in the observation 5 where I have a missing value. Had it been a name column at the place of ID, let me use that as well, where name is missing, so I can get the list. Okay, so right now I have got 9 records, or 9 observation I should say, that I have got 9 observation where name column is blank and we have got all the records. So this is how you know you can use is null or is missing in your examples while subsetting a data set. So now let's move to the next slide that says contains. So contains, contains is the condition. It will check the value, it will check the value of a variable to see whether the specified characters are found, and will output only when the condition is true. The condition is here a case sensitive. Why? Because you are going to give your value into inverted commas. So for example, consider this code that proc print data is equal to cards, where model contains convertible, and run. So this will output all the observation that have convertible included in the model name. If any of has convertible, it will not be included, right? So why it's convertible will not be included? Because in that case, the case is different. So it says that contains is case sensitive because you are writing that into inverted commas. I told you already that if you're writing anything into, you know, inverted commas or single quotes, that would be case sensitive. And until unless if you're not writing that into inverted commas, it will not be case sensitive. So convertible, right? Now contains works, you can say more or less same as like in SQL Server. We have like in SQL Server, and here we have contains. You must have used contains in Excel. So exactly the same way it will work for you. So let me go and create where, okay, let me proc print data is equal to SAS help dot cards. I'll say where make contents run. Now what make will contain, that I will have to check it out from the data set because I really don't know. Okay, let me say Pontiac. Okay, P-O-N. Let's see it works or not. I need to go to this, and I will write here P-O-N-T. Okay, now let's see that what I'm going to get. I've run this statement and I have got the result. I've got all the records where I have make as Pontiac. Alright, so it worked for me. Now if I go back and check out into let us suppose say model, and then I will find grand. Okay, oh no, I'll go here at the place of make, I will change it to model and then contains, and I will write here brand. Alright, let's see what it's gonna give. I have run this query and it has given me all the records where grand word was used in the model variable. So this is how your model variable works, or you can, not the exactly model variable, the contains function works for you. Alright, now let's move. Okay, let me show you one more thing. As I said that convertible and convertible with the different case will be different thing for you. So I'm gonna use grand as G in small or the lowercase. Now let's see whether I'll be getting any record or not. Okay, I've run that. Let's see what log window says. Log window says that no observation was selected from the dataset SAS help.cards. There was zero observation read from the dataset. Why? Because I have just changed the case of G here. If I change it again, I will get back all the records for the grand, like 8 observation. Alright, so it would be clear now that contains is case sensitive and how basically it works for you. Okay, now I'll be moving to the next slide, which says like. Okay, so like is again the same thing I told you, that like is the contain is working, or like works into the SQL server as well. To explain like, we need to use another data set with data taken about some aircraft operated by Air India. We create the following data set, right? They have taken an example where data airline length, call sign 8, departure 10, arrival 10. Now after that they are, you know, inputting them. So input, call sign, departure, arrival. They have taken three variables, call sign, departure and arrival. Okay. And then they have used data line and ran the program. So let us create the similar program for us so that we know we can work with it. So let me run the same program for you. I'll go ahead and paste the code. Now if you, okay, let me create this into Satya so that it will be, you know, available every time whenever I will look for it. So Satya, and if I want to use proc print and run, I'll get the output here. Yes, this is the output for me. Now let's see that what they wanted to do with the example. Now the following code outputs all observation where value of variable call sign takes the value starting with AI89 followed by character. Over here our data gives the output as those observation having call sign values AI891 and AI892. Prop print data Air India where call sign like this. So again, you are giving into inverted commas, so this is also going to be case sensitive. Now let's say in the same data set I will make some changes. Data is equal to Satya dot Air India. Now where call sign like inverted commas, and I can, let's say if I give Delhi, okay, DE, sorry, AI, because it's call sign, I have given 9. Let's see what I'm going to get. Oh no, I haven't got anything. It said that proc print data is equal to satya.airindia where call sign like A9. Oh, so you can see that I have got errors that is in highlighted into red color, and it said that syntax error while parsing where clause, and you can, you know, go through the log and you can find it out that what could be the wrong. It said that syntax error statement will be ignored. Why my statement will be ignored if I have written it, right? So you know that in SAS you need to terminate your statement using semicolon every time, and if you're not using that, it means you are creating a mistake. So I have used it again and I will run it. Let's see now what happens. It said that no observation was selected from this. So now the query ran, but it did not select any observation. Okay. So let's go back to the slide and what it said. It said that you need to use the call sign this. Okay. So how many variables you want? Let's see. I will give 2. Okay. And then if I run. No observation was selected from data satya.airindia. Okay, so it's not doing that for me. Let's see what I'm doing wrong. I've written proc print data is equal to satya.airindia where call sign, let me change like AI. Okay, I understand. So after A9 there are 3 variables, that is why I didn't get any record. Okay, so if I run this now, I'm sure I will get 2 records. Okay, so basically you need to mention that what is the width, and if that width is available over there in the data set, then definitely you will get output, or otherwise you won't. So this is how, you know, like works, but you need to be sure of that, the length. Let's do the same example with departure column. So now this time I'll be using departure at the place of call sign, and I will use DE, and for Delhi I have 3, 1, 2, 3. Okay. Now let me run it and let's see whether I get any record or not. Okay, I've got 3 records. So this is how, you know, you're gonna work with like operator. Now then after this, okay, it said that the following code outputs all observation where the value of variable call sign takes the value starting with AI8 followed by any 2 characters. Hence 2 underscores over here, our data gives 5 values as output, all starting with AI8. So proc print data is equal to Air India where call sign like AI8 and 2 spaces. It means 2 underlines which underscores you need to give. And as soon as they have given it, they got 5 records or 5 observations as an output. Now earlier the underscore allows us to have 1 character that takes any value. If we use the percentage symbol, it can substitute any number of characters. The following code will output any number of digits as following AI. The proc print data is equal to Air India semicolon where call sign like AI. Okay, now this is the best thing, or I would say the best practice to use. So at the place of giving those underlines or underscores, had it been, I would have given percentage sign, I would have got all the records in one go. And this is the best practice to know, or you can follow the same. Alright, I have got the same result, but I have just used percentage. Now you need not to know whether how many spaces you need to use or how many characters you need to use. So let's say if I say P, I have just done P. So I will get all the records, whether it is Port Blair, whether it is Pune, I will get both the records into my output. So I've just run that, and you can see that Pune and Port Blair are there, because this is exactly how it works. Now there is another thing. Let's say if I change it to B, and I use a percentage sign before it and a sign after it. So it will give me all the records where B is in the departure name. You can say Mumbai, Allahabad and Port Blair. I've got four records, and in all the records, at the place of records, I should say observation. So in each observation, we have B in it. Alright, so this is how you can use like to filter out your data. Now it says the following will output only those that have departure ending with I, right? So they have used percentage sign before the character. Now it will give you all the records where with records where departure is ending with this character. Note, whenever using like with percentage, try to keep the value enclosed in single quotes and not double quotes. Do you remember why? Later on, you will learn the macros, and you will see that if you use double quotes, the macro value will resolve, potentially leading to wrong output. So it is in the advanced SAS macros wherein we'll be writing a SAS variable into double quotes and with the percentage sign. So to avoid that, we need to write our, you know, values in single quotes with the percentage sign here while using like. Alright, so till now we have, you know, today we have covered between and, then we have used where a like contains. So we have, you know, covered some of them, some of the, you know, major topics today to subset our data. So that's all for today. If you have any question, just let me know at train2dataminers.com, and I will be happy to help. That's all for today. Tomorrow we'll be covering some more advanced topics into SAS. Till then, goodbye. Thank you.